Hello everyone and welcome to the Extreme TIG channel. So for today's video, we're going to talk about needle purge and how to weld with needle purge. So this is continuation of the previous video. You can check it up, it's going to be somewhere on the screen. So the use of the needle purge reduce the amount of argon you got to spend to fill all that entire system, which is way too expensive and it'll be just a waste of argon. That's why we got to do locally dams on both sides. The dam for needle purge, there's no any vent holes on the dam. They're just solid good dams on both sides. I got two joints here and they're approximately 4 inches from that bevel, or 100 mil on this diameter. And the needle purge is the setup, basically as the needle is going to poke into that bevel. This is a needle purge setup with a hose connected to the flow meter. I got single flow meter with a double control, so you can control the amount that in and out. The one side of the hose is connected to the argon bottle, the other one you control the argon flow that's gonna go into your bevel, into your joint. So basically I got one hole here, but there's like four holes. Depends how much argon you want to have filled in. So I'm gonna start with the one hole if it's probably not enough, and then I'm gonna open a couple more holes on that needle purge. So basically you poked in on the top, is I'm gonna start welding on the bottom, and just set it up like so it doesn't move, stays there. I don't want to go too deep, that's why I got only one single hole open on that needle purge, and then I'm just gonna tape it around. And once it's taped, make sure just the needle is steady, doesn't move, it doesn't fall out from that joint. And for the argon flow, I'm gonna set up just for initial to fill it up around 20 cubic feet per hour, 20-25, which is around 11 liters per minute. And once I start welding, I'm gonna lower down, I'm gonna reduce that flow to around 15 cubic per hour, or 7-8 liters per minute. So I'm gonna poke one hole, it's gonna be like a vent hole. The best way to check your purge if it's good with a lighter, as you can see here, so the flow is coming, the argon is going out, that's good, so that means dams are working. Now before I start, I'm gonna lower down to, as I said, 15 cubic feet per hour, or 7-8 liters. And for this procedure, you gotta be preheat to 400 Fahrenheit. Now with the preheat, don't go too crazy, just keep it local on both sides, slowly. Don't go close to those dams, you don't wanna burn them out, even though there is a procedure burning out the dams, but there's no need, it's a single layer dam, so it's gonna be washed right away, dissolved once the pipe is in service. So I'm using filler wire 1/8, start from the bottom, back feed. I'm running around 120 amps, 1/8 tungsten, and the filler wire is ADS B3. As I said, this is P22 chrome. I'm doing a back feed all the way up to the side, climbing up to the wall around 8 o'clock, 9 o'clock. This is where I got one tag, this is gonna stop. That's the root color. Looks good, that's all matters. So the purge is awesome, we got lots of meat inside, so I'm not worried about any sag back. As you can see, this is a heavy wall pipe, it's 4 inch. Now I'm gonna just reposition that needle purge. I'm gonna set it up on this side, as I'm going on the other side. I'm not gonna touch that top tack until this is gonna be the last step for the top part. So I'm going to reposition on the other side as I'm going up from the bottom up on the opposite side. So the same thing. Once you got good setup, it's pretty much same as welding carbon. It also depends from the grade of the chrome. So in this case, P22. It's not that bad. If it's a P91, that's a little bit trickier, as it's a little bit harder to manipulate that rod. But as long as you got really good clean prep, a really nice setup, shouldn't be any issues. So for the gap, you see here, it's 532, tight 532. Okay, now I gotta leave a window on the top for QC. This is a closure weld, so closure weld procedure requires QC to check the root. Once he's happy with the root, then you can close it up. That's inside. Looks good, looks clean. Okay, so before you closing, you wanna put that needle purge back in. I'm gonna put a little bit more weld, and before I close, I'm just gonna pull out the needle purge. As you can see here, now I left a little window. Now I'm gonna fill it up. I'm gonna go up around 20, 25 cubic feet per hour, which is around 11, 12 liters per minute. And I'm gonna fill it up, let it stand like for maybe 5 minutes, just in case you want to make sure. You double check if your dam is still working, because we put lots of heat inside. And just pull it out and just start welding. And all that, the concentration of the argon should be good enough for you to finish that tie-in on the top. As you can see here, there's lots of argon inside. It's actually pushing that puddle outside, so it's not actually sagging down. It's not prone to sag, as should be, like, because the gravity. So that means we got lots of argon inside. And for the tie-in, go back. As soon as I reach that tie-in point, I stretch that puddle left to right, and I go one, two steps back, and then I go over it again, and just and then finish like half an inch from that tie-in point and finish on the side. Okay, that's it. Now I'm gonna focus on the other joint. As I said, I got two joints here. I gotta do both in the same time, as it's a closure weld procedure, so I wanna do both joints in the same time. QC is gonna check if everything is good. I'm gonna close it up, and then gotta be filled, and that's it for the fill. So you gotta put heat blankets, they just keep the temperature. You gotta be slowly cooled down, no rapid cool down. You gotta be exposed to environment, so you just wrap it in a heat blanket, and that's gonna keep that weld to slowly cooling down, which is post weld procedure before you start welding. So for the fill, I'm gonna go hot pass. For hot pass, I'm running around 160 amps here. I'm putting a little bit bigger hot pass here with 1/8. All the time I'm just using 1/8 for entire weld. From root to cap, it's gonna be everything, it's gonna be welded with 1/8 filler wire. And once I'm filled to flash, both joints I'm doing the same time. I go here, one joint filled to flash, then I let it cool down, wrap it in a blanket, then I go do the other one. It'll be easier once you start putting cap, you know, when it's not really too hot. There's a 650 Fahrenheit interpass procedure, so you also gotta be careful for your interpass. The interpass is just passes, between passes. So you wanna kind of monitor with the temp stick. In this case, we got a temp stick and then we check for interpass. And it's gonna be three pass cap on each side. And that's it for the needle purge. As I said, the most important thing, if you got a really nice, good, proper setup for your needle purge, make sure the good prep, everything nice and clean, really good dams, so you know once you put the dam, it's not gonna break. Don't go too crazy if you got a preheat, so you don't burn the dams. Make sure there's no any water inside, so it doesn't break your dam. And as I said, check with the lighter. Every time when you weld, especially on a root, always check, you know, on your vent hole if your argon is coming out, and extinguish your fire on your lighter. You know the dam's working. You can also check, you know, with your hand, or that's how you know the dams are working and they're good. And that's it, guys. And both welds are done, and that's it. Hope you guys like it. Enjoy, learn something new. I hope it helps. As I said, good setup, good proper setup. That's the key for success. Like, share, subscribe if you didn't, and you gotta burn to learn, guys. There's no other way around. See you in the next one. Take care.